What is up? Season 4 of BattleBots. We are here in one of my favorite robots pits. This is Bronco, and I'm joined by Xander and Reason, two veterans. They've been at it for a long time, and there's no other bot quite like this one in the competition. Guys, thank you so much for taking some time here.
Thanks for coming by.
I noticed that a couple seasons ago, we got a really great shot on TV of that VEXnet joystick. Tell me about that. How's your experience been using the same control system that millions of kids around the world use on their robots?
And I think it's a great choice because it fits in your hands really well, and we all have a little bit of experience with controllers like this. So
totally.
That's a natural, but the biggest thing I'd say is like the whole VEXnet world with this robot, there's a lot of really complicated valving and sequencing and all the controller programming for the mixing curves, and it allows us to have an incredible amount of functionality and choices that we can make between the robots for how it drives and how it all works. So it's powerful.
Yeah, and we get our laptop plugged into this thing, and we can watch how Reason's controlling it. We can change those curves,
and totally. We
can actually reprogram it over the air. And so the design cycles of like, did that work? Did this work? Did that work? It just goes. It becomes instantaneous. Where and there's the speed controllers are also by VEX, and they take programmability of how much current that they can use, or if they have braking or coasting, and all that stuff we can program. And to make the robot drive nicely.
You're talking about the fundamentals and the lessons that you would learn. Are these lessons and fundamentals that apply to non-combat robots, general engineering fields, general engineering jobs? I mean, what's your experience been in that regard?
The cool thing about this sport is that it pulls from absolutely every part of engineering and design and kind of creative thinking and all of that, as well as actually physically building the thing and then running it. And so that's universal across anything. And it also generally teaches you how to work with other people, because it's pretty rare that you're doing these kind of things alone.
That's true. What is the kind of most exciting thing that has happened to you all in this particular filming session?
One of the interesting things about the way this robot got made this year was that we made titanium arms.
Okay.
And these usually could take almost a week of welding time to do, because you have to work very slowly with argon shielding gas. And Reason had the idea of actually making a completely enclosed box with like gloves that you reach into, and we flooded that whole box with argon.
Oh, wow.
And we're able to put these together in a day each instead of a week each.
No kidding.
Yeah.
And that's Bronco for you. Keep an eye out for them in the battle box, powered by VEXnet.